जय राधा माधवा कुंज विहारे
Prabhupada Jaya
Prabhupada. Parivrajakacharya Astaturu Shishyamat Divine Grace Shila Abhai Charanaravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Shila Prabhupada Ki ISKCON Founder BBT Founder Shila Prabhupada Ki Anantakoti Vaishnava Vrindaki Antaraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Vyasadev ki, Guru Parampara ki, Bhakti Vedanta Purports ki, Natai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bo. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. This is Canto 1, Chapter 17, Punishment and Reward of Kali, Text number 42. Vishasya Nastams Trim Pada Tapaha Socham Iti Pratisandadha Ashvasya Mahi Cha Samavadayat. Vrishasya Nastam Strim Padam Socham Dayamiti.
Socham Dayamiti.
Pratisandadha Ashvasya.
Pratisandadha Ashvasya.
Mahim Cha Samavadayat.
Mahim Cha Samavadayat.
Go ahead.
Mahim cha samavadayat.
one more person. Devotee was saying it together. He can say it. Can of the bull, the personality of religion, nastam, lost, three, padam, legs, tapara, austerity, socham, cleanliness. Daya, mercy. Iti, thus. Pratisandadhe, re-established. Ashvasya, by encouraging activities. Mahim, the earth. Cha, and. Samavardayat, perfectly improved. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. Translation. Thereafter, the king re-established the lost legs of the personality of religion, the bull, and by encouraging activities he sufficiently improved the condition of the earth. Purport. By designating particular places for the personality of Kali, Maharaj Parikshit practically cheated Kali. In the presence of Kali, Dharma in the shape of a bull and the earth in the shape of a cow, he could actually estimate the general condition of his kingdom. And therefore he at once took proper steps to re-establish the legs of the bull, namely austerity, cleanliness and mercy. And for the general benefit of the people of the world, he saw that the gold stock might be employed for stabilization. Gold is certainly a generator of falsity, intoxication, prostitution, enmity, and violence. And under the guidance of a proper king or public leader, or a brahmana or sannyasi, the same gold can be properly utilized to re-establish the lost legs of the bull, the personality of religion. Maharaj Parikshit, therefore, like his grandfather Arjuna, collected all illicit gold kept for the propensities of Kali and employed it in the Sankirtan Yajna as per instruction of the Srimad Bhagavatam. As we have suggested before, one's accumulated wealth may be divided into three parts for distribution, namely 50% for the service of the Lord, 25% for the family members and 25% for personal necessities. Spending 50% for the service of the Lord or for propagation of spiritual knowledge in society by way of Sankirtan Yajna is the maximum display of human mercy. People of the world are generally in darkness regarding spiritual knowledge, especially in regard to the devotional service of the Lord. And therefore, to propagate the systematic transcendental knowledge of devotional service is the greatest mercy that one can show in this world. When everyone is taught to sacrifice 50% of his accumulated gold for the Lord's service, certainly austerity, cleanliness and mercy automatically ensue, and thus the lost three legs of the personality of religion are automatically established. When there is sufficient austerity, cleanliness, mercy and truthfulness, naturally Mother Earth is completely satisfied and there is very little chance for Kali to infiltrate the structure of human society. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Janabhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaya Tadati Swapadantikam Vanchakalpa Tadubhyascha Kripa Sindubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanabhyo Vaishnavabhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shrivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Once also Srila Prabhupada was quite ill and he agreed to his disciples arranging for him to take some sort of transcendental retreat. So they arranged for Srila Prabhupada to travel from Los Angeles to Hawaii. And we have ISKCON temples in Hawaii. So Srila Prabhupada was staying in a devotee's bungalow on the beach to recover his health as requested by his disciples. But Srila Prabhupada transformed that retreat into a translation or writing retreat. And he only requested that two persons be with him. He is a personal cook and servant and his secretary, no one else. That means no management issues. So, the second or third evening, night, the servant, tucked Srila Prabhupada into his bed. And he had his own key, and Prabhupada had his own key to his room. And he switched off the light, and he left the room, and he locked the door from the outside. Because Prabhupada can always come from inside the room with his own key. So he walked across the garden pathway to his room and across the other side. So when he went into his room and he switched the light off for himself to take rest, and then he observed that the light suddenly came on in Srila Prabhupada's room. So he wouldn't dare go back, but he was curious of what's really going on. So he left his light off in case Srila Prabhupada may see that he's still got his light on in his room. He went back tiptoeing to the door, and he wouldn't dare put his face into the window because Prabhupada may catch him because of the outside light, the garden light. So what he did, he took his ear, because there was no key and the keyhole, and he placed it there, and he was hearing. And the Supreme Personality of Godhead, click. Sarvakara Karanam, click. So then he understood that Srila Prabhupada was doing translation and writing, yes. And he was speaking into his dictaphone, and by seeing the commentaries of the previous acharyas and so forth, he was translating Srimad Bhagavatam. So he tiptoed back to his room, and every half an hour, without sleeping, he'll go up and see the light is still on. So morning came, and he went as usual in the morning to Srila Prabhupada's room. He didn't say anything. And that particular morning, Srila Prabhupada said, "Okay, I am having enough energy now, I want to go for my morning walk." Because in Srila Prabhupada's health is not well, he doesn't go for his walk also, there's no energy. But this particular morning, he was enthusiastic to go for his morning walk. So on the morning walk, Srila Prabhupada takes his cane for balance. As he is walking, then Srila Prabhupada put his cane into the sand on the beach. And he looked at his servant, because he can perceive that he wants to speak. He says, "So?" Then he said, "Srila Prabhupada, it appears that you did more translation than usual throughout the night." Like that. Then Srila Prabhupada said, "Oh, you didn't take rest?" He switched it. And then the servant, he didn't go more further. Like that. So Prabhupada walked further, and then he put his cane firm into the sand, and then he spoke to his personal servant. And he said, "You know the translation from Sanskrit? That I could do very quickly." That I could do very quickly. And he said, "But it takes time to make it presentable for the common man." So here we see a very deep point, that the Sanskrit and the word for word and the English translation is important. Yes? Important. But anyone can do that. Yeah. One devotee in Tirupati told me He's like the vice president there. He's from Guntur, tall. From Tirupati here. Madhu Gopal Hari, what's his tall? Rupesh, yeah. He's from Guntur, right? If originally, he preaches that. He's from that area, yeah. So he told me when I was in Tirupati some years ago, he told me, Maharaj, there's one village here. It's a very, you know, less known village in Andhra Pradesh. Yeah. He said, Maharaj, when you walk in that village and you speak to anybody, they'll respond only in Sanskrit. When they go to market to buy sabji, you know, or fruits or flowers, or to the shop to groceries, they speak in Sanskrit. Like the shopkeeper will speak in Sanskrit, the person who is coming to buy and speak in Sanskrit. A child is born, has grown up in Sanskrit language. So it's not a big deal, it's not a big deal. And then someone in the Western world in Harvard University will get a PhD in Sanskrit. But yes, Sanskrit is an everyday language, it's the language of the demigods. You know? So therefore Srila Prabhupada himself, he was born with Sanskrit, of course with Bengali, but also Sanskrit. You know? He said, oh, the translation, that I could do very quickly. But it takes time to make it presentable for the common man. And that's how practically all of us came to embrace and came to practice a Krishna consciousness. It's only through the purports. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, certainly. It's only through the Bhaktivedanta purports. There's no other way. See? So in this particular purport, Srila Prabhupada is speaking about transcendental knowledge, the propagation of transcendental knowledge. And that means a transcendental book distribution. Yes. Srila Prabhupada said that the BBT, Bhaktivedanta Book Trust, which publishes and prints our books as a separate entity, he said the BBT, the Bhaktivedanta Book Trust, is my heart. Is my heart. And ISKCON, which distributes the books, is my body. Is my body. And then he added one more, which is lesser known. And the monies that the collectors, the Lakshmi, that is collected from this transcendental book distribution, Srila Prabhupada said, is my blood. Is my blood. So in other words, we cannot even misuse one farthing for any expense, but especially money that comes from book distribution. It's my blood. That is a lesser known one. His Holiness Gaurat Swami told me that. And Srila Prabhupada said the third one also. So what is it? The Bhaktivedanta Book Trust, Prabhupada said, is my heart. ISKCON is my body. And the monies that are collected by the book distribution that comes into the book fund account is my blood. At one time in a class in Mayapur, one of Srila Prabhupada's early disciples who joined Srila Prabhupada in San Francisco in 1968. In fact, two brothers joined. He joined and his elder brother joined. So Srila Prabhupada initiated him as Makanlal Das. And his elder brother, who also served as Srila Prabhupada's personal servant for some years, Prabhupada named him Naran Rayan Das. So our Makanlal Prabhu, some years ago, he entered into the sannyas ashram, and his sannyas initiated name is Bhakti Madhurya Madhava Swami. I believe he's based in Punjabi Bagh temple. He stays there. Yeah. He's an amazing person. It's like he's very innocent in his ways when he does things. It's like a child in an old body. Very innocent. Amazing person. So he was giving a class in Mayapur around in Magopunim March around 2011. And he was explaining that how in several occasions Srila Prabhupada directly said that he directly descended from Goloka Vrindavan. Directly, he came from there. So that indicates Srila Prabhupada is not a sadhana siddha. Srila Prabhupada is a nitya siddha. He is eternally established in Krishna consciousness. He doesn't need to perform sadhana to become purified. See? Then he quoted one person who was actually in the class also, one of Srila Prabhupada's early disciples, known as Bhavananda Prabhu. He quoted, and Bhavananda Prabhu acknowledged that this is a fact. Yeah. So Srila Prabhupada told more than one disciple this, what I'm about to say, but he especially said he told Bhavananda Prabhu, who is that? Yeah. And Srila Prabhupada said, you know, I was in Goloka Vrindavan with Krishna, and Krishna requested me, I want you to go to the material world. And Srila Prabhupada replied to Krishna, what is that? Because when you're in Goloka Vrindavan, you don't know that there's a material world. There's no such thing that exists. You know, as a matter of fact of speaking, you know, proper inquiry from Krishna. You know, Shama Sundar, Krishna, Goloka Vrindavan. Where is that place? We never heard of that place in Golok. So Krishna started explaining that, you know, I also went there, you know, myself, and I spoke, you know, Bhagavad Gita. But still, despite speaking the Bhagavad Gita, I wanted to come back home, back to us here. Still, they're not listening. And Srila Prabhupada asked Krishna, oh, what do you want me to do? I don't know where that place is, but what do you want me to do? He said, no, you must go there. Because I want you to write all these books that supports my teachings that I have left behind. And they're still not understanding this place is like that. And this is Kali Yuga, you know. Ayushya Sabya Kala Asman Yuge Janaha Manda Sumanda Matava Manda Bhagya Padrata. That's that people's memories are very short-lived, their lives are also short-lived. They can't retain something for very long in the memory. See? And Manda Bhagya, so they are most unfortunate. Upadrata, and above all, they are always disturbed. Yeah. And that teachings is in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the first canto. Okay. So then Srila Prabhupada replied to Krishna, can you bring these people this way, they can, the Hindi translation is in the back, ask them to go. They're visiting, you know. They know English, that's fine. So Srila Prabhupada replies to Krishna, "Oh, that place doesn't sound like a good proposition. I don't really want to go. Because if I go, I won't be with you." You know, like that. Then Krishna emphatically replied, and this is our Bhakti Madhurya Madhava Swami, he put his hand up, and Krishna said like this, "You must go, because I want you to write these books to support my teachings so they can understand my teachings. You must go." See? And it's in the same way that enters into the disciplic succession. Whatever Krishna requested Srila Prabhupada to do, whatever his inner identity is in Goloka Vrindavan, is the same thing that corresponds exactly with Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's words to Srila Prabhupada, which is prophetic. In other words, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told Srila Prabhupada, "Oh, you are an educated young man speaking English. Why don't you spread Lord Chaitanya's movement around the world in the English-speaking language?" Same thing that Krishna requested Srila Prabhupada. And then later Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur made another prophetic statement when he said that Srila Prabhupada did not have to join the Gaudiya Math. And he said, "It is better that he is living outside your company. He will do. When the time comes, he will do everything himself. You don't have to recommend him." See? And Srila Prabhupada only received these statements from his Guru Maharaj. But nobody else was spoken like that. Any other disciple of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was not spoken in that way. See? Then we know in November 1935, Srila Prabhupada had traveled from Bombay, Mumbai to Vrindavan and to see his spiritual master, which is actually the last meeting they had, because on 1st January or the night of December 31st, 1935, going into 1st January 1936, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur left this world. So it was barely 2 months before, in November 1935, during the Vrajmandal Parikrama, Srila Prabhupada Abhay Charan, Charan Aravinda Das at that time, was walking on the banks of Radha Kund in the sacred association of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And there he received that final instruction, which was the very first instruction that he received in 1922. See? And he received it even as the final instruction, which is the same request and insistence or persistence of Sri Krishna himself in Goloka Vrindavan. And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur instructed our Abhay Charan Aravinda, our Srila Prabhupada, "I had a desire to print books. If you ever get money, you print books." Of course, after printing means, and distribute them profusely throughout the world. Like that. So, another close disciple of Srila Prabhupada who was serving him as a personal servant, his name is Nanda Kumar Prabhu. So, when he used to serve Srila Prabhupada, and he remembers, Srila Prabhupada regularly at that time, when it's winter, He used to take, you know, like hot milk at night, just before taking rest. So sometimes Srila Prabhupada would take some, maybe, what you call mudli, puffed rice? Muri, puffed, sometimes like that, you know, made by the servant, you know, roasted, and, yeah, by the servant, yeah. But usually it takes hot milk. So one night, Ananda Kumar Prabhu took the hot milk as usual in the evening before Prabhupada could take rest. And he saw there was like a special energy immediately right away in the room which was not regularly there. So he observed while taking the hot milk and walking to that low desk with the lamp light on the low desk. And he observed Srila Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada was sitting at his desk and he was reading his own Krishna book. You know, with his, he had this like wire and glasses. You'll see those glasses in his quarters, in his rooms in Vrindavan. So Nanda Kumar Prabhu, he set the milk in front of Srila Prabhupada. And then Srila Prabhupada looked up at him, acknowledging he brought the milk. And he had this very innocent, sort of a beautiful childlike, you know, caricature face, like that. Caricatures on his face. Yeah. And Srila Prabhupada told Ananda Kumar Prabhu, you know, when I read these books, it's hard to believe that I wrote them. It's hard to believe that I wrote them. And every time I read these books, I learn something new. Now, from the material perspective, if there's an author and writer of a book, and if he speaks like that, somebody will think he's going pagla, you know. He doesn't know what's in his own book, he wrote it. Yeah. Like that. So in the same way, Nanda Kumar Prabhu was a little bit confused, but he didn't say that Prabhupada went pagla or something, no. But he was confused. And Prabhupada, you translated his books with great pains. And earlier on in the lecture we said, and it takes time to make it presentable for the common man. And Nanda Kumar Prabhu was like, what's going on here? Like that. Then Srila Prabhupada laid it straight from his heart. He said, actually, I didn't write these books. Krishna is dictating and I am writing. This way he's able to read them and learn something new. Krishna is dictating and I am writing. He said Krishna is writing, but you know, Krishna is dictating and I am writing. Srila Prabhupada ki, Transcendental Book Distribution ki. You have any comments or questions you'd like to ask? Keep your hands raised so he knows where to give the microphone. Everyone knows him? He's a member of the Leeds program. And tell them your name.
My name is Simha Gaur Das.
Simhadwarha Prabhu. Tell us.
Simha Gaur Das.
Simha?
Gaur.
I thought it's the door. You have to go to Simha Dwar to go to Simha Ghor Prabhu. So I entered the door first, then I can take your darshan. Okay, Simha Gaur Prabhu, now I can see you.
Maharaj, thank you very much for so beautiful explaining the position of Srila Prabhupada. Just have a question that in the beginning days of Krishna consciousness, Prabhupada so much emphasized on book distribution and Harinam Sankirtan. As the time progressing, sometimes there is a feeling in the devotees that book distribution is direct preaching is more important than book distribution.
What do you mean by direct preaching?
Preaching personally, one to one, or preaching to people.
So that they become attached to you, right? And you become their God. Go on with your question.
So, so how we can keep?
How I can keep?
Sorry. Prabhupada, what Prabhupada emphasized, the book distribution, Harinam Sankirtan as a priority.
If you understand the goal of why Srila Prabhupada said that, then you'll do it. You see, there are 6.6 billion people on the planet. How many?
7 billion.
And in India alone is 1.4 billion. Even if you take birth a billion times, you won't be able to finish this preaching of book distribution. When the world accepts that the actual brahmanas, the actual brahmanas are brahmanas from the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, then the book distribution is having effect, and then ISKCON is having effect on the world. Srila Prabhupada in another place indicated that even if 5%, how many percent? 5% of the 7 billion become devotees, practicing devotees, then the world can change immediately within 18 days. Within?
18 days.
Way back in 1968, Srila Prabhupada wrote a letter from America, somewhere, either New York or San Francisco. Yeah, he wrote a letter to Pope John Paul V1, the sixth. You know, Roman numeral V1, the sixth, or VI. Okay. Inducing the Pope that I want to meet with you, and I have a grand plan. See? But whether the Pope received the letter, whether the Pope read the letter, we do not know. It's in there, in the Srila Prabhupada Lilamrita, in the appendix, the letter. It's in the seventh volume. You have six volumes of Lilamrita. It's in the seventh one, additional pastimes. It's in the back of the book. Very nice letter. 1968. So when the Muslims and when the Christians and when the Hindus, you know, and when the Buddhists and when the Jews, or everyone who's connected to some type of dharma, accept that the leading spiritual personalities to accept advice from are the brahmanas from the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, then we would know that our book distribution efforts are complete. Srila Prabhupada indicated only 5% of the population may follow the four regulative principles and chant minimum 16 rounds daily. And that too, out of those persons, only those who have an inclination to be Brahmanical will be then, there will be less than the 5%. Far less. Most will be Vaishyas and Kshatriyas. And another purport, Srila Prabhupada says, I have the reference in my books and my computers and in my notes. Srila Prabhupada says that, you know, we think that second initiation means Brahman initiation. The answer is no. You know, when you get the sacred thread, that does not make you a Brahmana. That does not make you a Brahmana. I mean a real, genuine, true Brahmana. Because Srila Prabhupada said that the sacred thread, which means second initiation, you know, is also given to Kshatriyas and Vaishyas. It doesn't mean that they are second initiated, they are Brahmanas. They're not. It's in the purport. But they are allowed to worship the deity, but they may not be necessarily be called the spiritual guides of society, the intellectual guides of society, because a Kshatriya and a Vaishya can be given the sacred thread which makes them eligible to even worship the deity, but not considered as Brahmanas. You understand? So therefore, even those personalities, even within ISKCON, who are inclined to make money, do management, banking, and you know, like that, doing management Kshatriya, you know, like that, banking, making money, Vaishyas. Well, even within ISKCON, International Service of the Krishna Consciousness, devotees understand their place. Then they will also respect the genuine Brahmanas within ISKCON, who are not involved in management and art, who are not involved in administration, who are not involved in banking, agriculture. They are Brahmanas. And these Brahmanas within ISKCON, they just hang around, you know, they just be around, you know. They just be around. They chant 64 rounds every day, they read the scriptures, they live simply nearby, and the king or the administrators go and visit them. See? So therefore, even within ISKCON, if we have to just listen to Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, this is not going to work for the world. It's not going to work for the world. See? So when we internally understand our position, where the Kshatriyas and the Vaishyas within ISKCON were doing administration, management, collecting money, seeing big people, you know, fundraising. When they respect the Brahmanas within ISKCON, then you can distribute more books. Then you can distribute more books. And then that will spill over to the masses of the people, of the like other, you know, almost 7 billion people. Oh, the real leaders, spiritual leaders of society are within the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, because even within the society they respect their spiritual leaders. See? So then when it comes to that point, you know, there is no more, you know, respecting my Kula Guru, my family priest, right? Because I own him. I control my family priest. I tell him, do this yajna, come here now, do that, there's the money, go. He's an employee. He's employed by the Kshatriya, the Vaishya. They control the Brahman, so-called priest. No? Purohit. You getting it so far? So when the genuine ISKCON Brahmanas, not the Kshatriyas and the Vaishyas, who are also second initiated within ISKCON, they are recognized within ISKCON, and when those genuine Brahmanas are recognized by others, then you will find people will gravitate towards these Brahmanas for spiritual guidance. They will not go to the Maulana. You know Maulana? Or a Mufti, he's a high priest in Muslim world. The Muslim will come to our Brahmanas. They will not go to like a bishop or a cardinal or a reverend or a Christian minister, you understand? They will not go to a rabbi. You understand? So that is why we have to distribute books. We have to distribute books. And there's like 800 million books we distributed since 1966 or 67. It's not sufficient, is not? Yeah. Because the book can go where the holy name cannot go. The holy name is Mridanga. And the book is Brihad Mridanga. And the book is non-different from the holy name. It is also non-different from the holy name. It can go to places where there is no electricity, where you cannot use computer and e-book readers. You understand? When there's no more energy through electricity, you can still read book, but you cannot put your computer on. And the book can reach places where there's no devotees, where there's no devotees. When somebody reads, becomes a devotee and makes others devotee in that place. That is called Priti Viti Acharadi Nagaradi Gram. Every town and village. Just like our Madhava Kant Prabhu. Where is he? Haribol. He's preaching in like one of the remote areas of or states of India, of Bharatvash, in a place called Sikkim. You heard of Sikkim? Yeah. So he's there and he's doing some pioneering preaching. It's just there were two of the brahmacharis and few devotee families who are not local, he invited them to come there. See? And he knows the value of book distribution because he's getting it translated into the local languages. He told me yesterday, right? He knows the value of that. He knows that even if we don't do much preaching through our temples and festivals, if the books are there, you know, and books are there, it will happen. It will happen. In Kadam Bihari Prabhu, you make sure you visit him in Sikkim. Okay, we'll go together. Because he needs Sangha and he's hungry for Vaishnav Seva. He's hungry for? He wants to serve, yes. Otherwise, one will be, to answer your question further, you know, one will be, you know, in his comfort zone, in his nice room in Punjabi bag, or Kanpur. See? I joined 36 years ago. Dhanavir Prabhu is probably 40 years in the movement. Right, Dhanavir Prabhu? How long? 40? Huh?
35.
Yes. It's as good as me, maybe better than me, 35, but I joined 36 years. He knows in the old days, in Vrindavan, there's no electricity for 5 days, only 2 days a week. Right? I used to stay in Vrindavan, 1989, 1991. There's no MVT and shops in the front. Everything was van, forest. Even parents used to come from Mangalati. Inside. Ask him, he'll tell you. No more parrots, everything is concrete. But, you know, there's no bisleri water, you know? Bottle water. We have to go to Goshala and take 2 5-liter, you know, from the well, you know, sweet water from the well, from Goshala. I used to live there. This is like 30 years ago, 1989. And no hot water in winter. was nice, it was a nice tapasya. But now everything there, fan, heater during winter, you know. See, you get used to that, you get used to that. So therefore you're not going out, you're not going out and distribute those books. Go to Sikkim, help him. And he told me yesterday also, Madhavakant, with the other devotees were walking, he said, and it has the highest literacy rate in India. That small state. People can read English. People can speak English. Yeah, that's what you said, right? So we can distribute English written books, you know, Prabhupada's English translations. Yeah. So that is the goal. The goal is that most people will not follow the regulative principles. Most people will not chant 16 rounds of japa daily. But when they accept that the spiritual leadership of the world is the brahmanas of ISKCON, then we know we have distributed books sufficiently. Did you know that even Christian leaders, Muslim leaders, and other leaders, and even Hindu leaders, they read Prabhupada's books, they read Prabhupada. So they go in front of their congregation, you know, in front of their following, they say things as if it's coming from the Bible, or the Quran, or the Torah. But it's not coming from that scripture, it's coming from who? From Prabhupada. And do you know sometimes these motivational speakers, you know, even devotees, it's called plagiarism. They steal from Prabhupada's words, and the way they present, you know, in a package, in an innovative way, and everyone's, wow, that fellow, man. Meanwhile, he read Prabhupada's purport, he put it in another package, you know, and he's giving there to everyone. You understand? And everyone becomes attached to him, not to Prabhupada. There's no transparency into a disciplic succession. But it's all right, it's all right. It's going out there. That is why we have to distribute books. Prabhupada said, I have only one disease. I only think big. And all of you cannot catch up with me. All of you cannot catch up with me. And then one disciple said, when Prabhupada said, the one disciple said, Prabhupada, that's also true when you walk. You walk so briskly, and we are less than half your age, and we are, you know, we are panting with breath, but you are walking. That means with everything, with everything. Simha Gaur.
Thank you, Raj Maharaj.
Do you want to become a temple president of a temple now? Do you want to become a GBC member? Do you want to be an initiating guru? See? We are not after position, power and politics. PPP. We should distribute books where there's no position, power and politics. And those who are there in that service of some Persian power and politics, they'll come and touch your feet, take your dust. Because without the propagation of Krishna consciousness and without the distribution of books, who will come to the temple? You cannot increase the number of persons, right? Only through the preaching effort you can increase. And then you can come and say, see, now you are a very big temple president. I introduce you to these people through book distribution. Please. Are we all right?
Thank you very much.
Time. Mahaprasade Govinde. Breakfast. Srila Prabhupada ki, Anantakuti Vaishnav Vrind ki, Transcendental Book Distribution ki, ISKCON Sikkim Yatra ki, Nitai Gaur Prem Anande Hari Hari.